show. Now, Diana, do you think that you yourself, are you a geek?
I think I'm a geek. What, my office thinks I'm a geek.
There you go. What's your geek flavor? What are you really into?
Oh, I love fantasy stuff. Nerd.
Fantastic. I'm cool with it. And last but not least, going here, Aaron, you work on a TV show, working waves. You're kind of a big deal. So what are you looking for when these folks come out the back here?
Well, like Belcher said, the devil is definitely in the details here. We were looking under people's skirts today to see their underpinnings.
There you go. Show us that nice armor butt. There you go. That's how we do it. One more time. Give it up. Are composed of a simple four-way stretch bandage. Around 730 hours to make this armor took much longer than we could imagine. Each piece was molded out of wood, even pyramid built on the top. The armor was hand painted. And let's be real, she looks absolutely fantastic. One more time. Reactor is made of copper wire, plexiglass, very diffuse lightning gels, and 14 feet of LEDs, running at 290 hours. Looking at the detailing is achieved through layering, scoring, gouging, layering the foam again. Look as you go, and they whip that around. Look at the very detail in the shield, the face, the whole nine yards. Everything about this is absolutely fantastic. One more time, give it up for Faison. Is painted by spray painting and acrylic paint. Use two types of fabric for the skirts, covered with vinyl, acrylic resin, and is painted by spray painting the fake leather boots, and the shield is made as the armor, and the sword as a base of two PVC pipe. The armor looks great, she looks great, give a big round of applause. Vinyl, and has a reptilian pattern to touch. Okay, you can't even tell, cosplay. The top was made out of a kind of poly blend, and the bra was dyed by hand, red and black. The boots were made by heat sealing and the vinyl to the boot base and hot gluing the details together. She looks fantastic. One more time, give it up for all the roads. That's all the Cosplayers. The costume is completely constructed from gauze and repurposed wedding dress material, all practically drowned in at least 10 various spray paints. Her headdress and veil weighs about 2 pounds, and after a long day at New York Comic Con, it sure gets heavy. And in this village lives a children's beggar with his wife. And the one she recently made into a movie by Disney, released in 2014, the sword platoon for this costume. The skirt is made up of 383 individually cut and sewn pieces of fabric from both of Joanne's and a secondhand craft store. Please. Put it next. We have Elon Costumes coming in as Yinaba of Vanapopongover. Sleeves and trousers, the gallery fur, the stitching ribbons and the sleeves and crying over it. And working that thing simply because I was able to bring a favorite character to life in about 60 hours. She looks fantastic. Take it all, give her a round of applause. Wow. Hours. and it is really, really creepy up close. I'm standing over here, bro. Nah. Man, no sir. No, you know black people eat first in the horror movies. That's not how this works. That's not how this works. One more time, give everybody a round of applause. Including a wig, tinted, and cut for the character, and custom-built aluminum belt buckle. She looks fantastic. With the lace are created using both machine and embroidery and hand crochet. The beaded snowflakes are made over 3,000 glass beads. The detail contains 200 fresh water pearls. Under this whole piece is a custom hoop skirt and 20 steel bottom corset. Are casted from resin and even have LED light inside. No 3D printing. She made these bad boys. The ring is now using two wings and all the fans and the time I give up for Tracer. From the Power Town Jones, $1 back in the water. Thermal plastic assembled with riveted leather straps. The emblems, metals, and small details were produced. Cold cast and aluminum. And bronze for 3D printed replicas. The leather was cut down and hand stitched to create the shins and holsters and codpiece. The hand sculpted and masks. It's by his hand that you will rise from the ashes of this world. Explosions. Tiny Tina. Big Lou spent over 100 hours bringing this smoky preteen to life. All of it is handmade from the scratch, painted over, and cell shaded over top of the tallest. With the benefit, she knows from every detail behind the scenes on her dress. She even set the costume for the succeeding how much. Well, I hate myself was the Facebook post that launched the Rabbit 5 crafting journey. She made this 2 weeks ago. Brought it to you guys on stage here at New York Comic Con. Look at her, give her a big round of applause. She is working it. Out of EVA foam and have small wire engines inside of them for sound and mobility. The arm and legs are made of EVA foam with a tailor-made detail on the cheese. I am brush in some places to get the right, absolute right look. Oh, she's taking it off. She's going to come up the back. She is not. That's right. Now that, attention to detail. Look at that, folks. Clap and scream for Junkrat. The full functioning head is a full skull along with a latex chest. We took over 3 months to create. The oversized shoes stand 15 inches tall and are made from EVA foam and cat litter panels. Can't wait for me to make the 200 hours of music designing, building, and Count Chocula 2.0. Just milk it. Milk it, Count Chocula. You don't know where you are right now. You are lost as hell. It's okay. Follow my voice. Follow my voice, Count Chocolate. Just come towards a short black man. Just come.
Yes, tall black man, come a short black man.
Come on over. Come on, come to Chocolate. Come on over here, brother. Including 4 weeks of vacation, more than a few all-nighters, and lots of help from family. Typical claws were constructed using foam mats, 3 types of plastic tubing, PVC fitting LEDs, and over 100 individually cut and painted pieces of insulation foam, all held in place by
four curves the over eyes. And I know you're asking, is it heavy? It is absolutely heavy. Give them a big round of applause, Aaron. Every Halloween costume party's worst nightmare right here. If he shows up to your costume contest, go home. You lost. Okay. Along with that, get another outlaw to the world. Announce our winners. Armor category, strike a pose. Give it to them. Give it to the people, folks. Give it to the people. Give it to the people. Give it to the people. Here we go, folks. Now time to announce our top three in the armor category. In third place, clap and scream for Alan Ward! Give it up for Alan Ward! In second place, clap and scream. For Phase on Juke, everybody! And now, in first place, in our armor category, they will step forth, claim their crown. Give it up. For Sci-Cat Cosplay! One more time, give them all a big round of applause! Thomas Banks, there you go! Everybody in, folks in our needlework category, strike a pose. Says on the card with a thorn cosplay. Let's give you a big round of applause, everybody. You're a friend. Category, give it up for Rattlin' Bear!
Come on down, brother. I know you got big old feet. Come on up there. You know what they say to a man about big feet? He got big shoes. Get on. Here we go. In third place. I just want to stand next to him for reference. This is why you should tell your children to eat their vegetables.
Right here. All right.
Ooh. All right. Watch yourself. Watch yourself. All right. And in first place, go crazy.
There you go, get that check in there. It's all about the money. There you go.
That's how she got off stage. I would have been mad as hell too.